Hello, my friend, Pastor Curt here, and I've got a question for you. How are you doing with all the interruptions? That's right. Now that we're all home stay sequestered, we're going to be interrupting each other a lot. It's happening at my house. I got a daughter, plays the piano, sings beautifully, but she always wants to do it exactly when I'm trying to record one of these videos. And I got a wife. She's making all these incredible masks, but she wants my help right when I'm trying to get on a Teams or a Zoom call for work. And I'm sure if they got on this camera, they'd tell you about all the times I have been interrupting them. You know, we've got to figure out how to not interrupt each other, except when it comes to divine interruptions. That's right. There's one type of interruption I want you to embrace. It's an interruption from God. You see, God likes to interrupt us. I mean, hello, this whole thing is one giant interruption that God's going to use to resort our lives. In fact, it happened to the Apostle Paul, and if it happened to the Apostle Paul, well, it's going to happen to you and I. In the book of Acts, it tells us the Apostle Paul and his whole team, they're traveling to a certain area where they're going to start a certain amount of churches, and God says, don't go there. Stop. Rethink. That night, Paul goes to sleep, and he has a dream. Acts 16, 9 through 10. During the night, Paul had a vision of a man of Macedonia standing and begging him, come over to Macedonia and help us. After Paul had seen the vision, we got ready at once to leave for Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. An old friend of mine, Harvey Herman, very learned man. I can remember back in the day, he's preaching this message and talking just about how unusual it would be, how against the odds it would be for Paul to go to this region of Macedonia. And yet, as soon as the Spirit interrupted him, he left right away. I wonder if you and I can be like that, listening for the voice of God to interrupt us and then acting immediately. You know, it might be as simple as God just saying, make a call right now, stop everything you're doing and call a friend and comfort them. Or it could be as major as God saying, in all of this, I have a brand new direction for your life. I want to tell you, my friend, the interruption of God, that divine interruption, it is always for our best. Embrace it, seek it, and act on it. Even today, spend some time looking for that interruption. And when you hear that still small voice telling you to change your plans, will you obey quickly and have a great day?